"Do you think you will be able to guide the bubble?" asked the Wizard.
"Oh, yes, I know enough magic to do that," replied Santa Claus. "You'll blow the bubble with me inside of it, and I'll be sure to get home in safety."
"Please send me home in a bubble, too," begged the Queen of Merryland.
"Very well, madam, you shall try the journey first," politely answered old Santa.
The pretty wax doll bade goodbye to the Princess Ozma and the others and stood on the platform while the Wizard blew a big soap bubble around her. When completed, he allowed the bubble to float slowly upward, and there could be seen the little Queen of Merryland standing in the middle of it and blowing kisses from her fingers to those below. The bubble took a southerly direction, quickly floating out of sight.
"That's a very nice way to travel," said Princess Fluff. "I'd like to go home in a bubble, too."
So the Wizard blew a big bubble around Princess Fluff, and another around King Bud, her brother, and a third one around Queen Zix. And soon these three bubbles had mounted into the sky and were floating off in a group in the direction of the Kingdom of Noland. The success of these ventures induced the other guests from foreign lands to undertake bubble journeys also, so the Wizard put them one by one inside his bubbles, and Santa Claus directed the way they should go, because he knew exactly where everybody lived. Finally, Button Bright said, "I want to go home, too."
"Why, so you shall," cried Santa, "for I'm sure your father and mother will be glad to see you again. Mr. Wizard, please blow a big fine bubble for Button Bright to ride in, and I'll agree to send him home to his family as safe can be."
"I'm sorry," said Dorothy with a sigh, for she was fond of her little comrade, "but perhaps it's best for Button Bright to get home, 'cause his folks must be worrying just dreadful."